Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have studied two different forms of linear equations which describe lines in the Cartesian plane. Either form may be more useful, depending upon what information is known about a line's graph. If we know the line's slope and y-intercept, then the slope-intercept form is the simplest way to write an equation which describes the line. The slope-intercept form is written as y equals mx plus b, where the constant m is the line's slope, and the constant b is the y-coordinate of the point where the line crosses the y-axis. On the other hand, if we don't know the y-intercept, but we do know the coordinates of some other point which lies on the line, then the point slope form is usually a more convenient way to write the line's equation. The point slope form is written as y minus y1 equals m times the quantity x minus x1, where m is the line's slope, and the constants x1 and y1 are the coordinates of a known point which lies on the line. In this chapter, we will introduce a third form of equation for a line, called the TwoPoint Form. We know from geometry that we cannot uniquely describe a line knowing only its slope, since any plane contains an infinite number of parallel lines with the same slope. Likewise, we cannot uniquely describe a line by specifying a point that lies on the line without specifying the slope, since there are an infinite number of lines with different slopes, which include any given point. To uniquely describe a line on a plane, we must specify both its slope and at least one point which the line includes. Both the slope-intercept and the point-slope forms are based on this type of description. The difference is that the slope-intercept form requires that the specified point lie on the y-axis, while the point slope form allows the given point to be anywhere on the xy plane. But there is another way to describe a line without specifying its slope. A line can be uniquely described by specifying two distinct points which the line includes. This principle is the basis for the two-point form of the equation for a line. This form does not require a line's slope to be known in order to create the line's equation. All that is required are the coordinates of two points which lie on the line. The two-point form can be created by starting with the point-slope form and replacing the line slope, m, with the formula for slope, which we learned in the chapter on slope. As you may recall, the formula for slope uses the coordinates of two distinct points through which the line passes. The coordinates of one point, x1 and y1, are constants already contained in the point-slope equation. But the coordinates of the second point, x2 and y2, are additional constants, which are required by the two-point form. To demonstrate how to use the two-point form, let's try an example using this form to write the equation for a line. Let's say that we are given the graph of a line, but not its equation. All we know about the line is that it passes through the points 3, 5, and 7, 8. Using the two-point form of the equation for a line, we assign the coordinates of the first point, 3 and 5, to the constants x1 and y1. Since x1 is 3 and y1 is 5, we replace x1 in the equation with 3 and y1 with 5. Likewise, we assign the coordinates of the second point, 7 and 8, to the constants x2 and y2. And so, in the equation, x2 and y2 are replaced with 7 and 8. Completing the arithmetic, 8 minus 5 is 3, and 7 minus 3 is 4. Of course, we could have accomplished the same thing by first using the slope formula to calculate the slope from the coordinates of the two known points. and then substituting this value for slope into the point slope form, along with the coordinates of either one of the points. Like the slope-intercept and point-slope forms, the two-point form cannot be used to describe a vertical line. This is because the x-coordinates of all points on a vertical line have the same value. No matter which two points we pick for the two-point form, the constants x1 and x2 will be equal. Since x1 and x2 have the same value, the denominator x2 minus x1 in the equation will be 0. The equation will therefore include a term divided by 0, which is undefined. There are many different forms of equations which describe lines in the xy plane. So far, we have discussed three of the most common forms. Any of these forms may be used to describe a specific line. The most convenient form to use depends upon what information is known about the line. In the next lecture, we will introduce one additional form of linear equation called the standard form.